he shocked the nation back in 1998 when he stormed onto the political scene and won Minnesota's gubernatorial race. Now, former Minnesota governor, pro wrestler, and Navy SEAL Jesse the Body Ventura is considering perhaps another political comeback. His book, Don't Start the Revolution Without Me, describes his outrage at the state of affairs in the U.S. It's now out in paperback. Good to see you.
Good to see you, Sean. Always.
I tell you, he's been yelling at me ever since he walked in the green room today. I mean, you went.
I don't yell at anyone.
You are just right on me. It's just like I just can't get 5 seconds to breathe.
It's your reputation that precedes you.
Well, you said you didn't like. You didn't think you would like me until you met me. Didn't you say that to me?
Yeah.
What didn't you like about me?
I don't always care for how it operates and the bullying of guests and things like that.
I couldn't bully you if for a million.
Not me, but other
people
you can.
You'd slap me down so hard I wouldn't.
Other people you do, and I get irritated when I see that at home.
Well, you said you've been out surfing the last 6 months. Have you really been in Mexico surfing for 6 months?
No, unfortunately, only for three because from November. Well, my brother-in-law was diagnosed with Lou Gehrig's disease.
Sorry to hear
that. And he was diagnosed October 2nd and he passed on January 14th. So I didn't get to Mexico till the end of January because my wife, it was her younger brother, and she stayed home and took care of him until his passing. Well, it's a horrible disease.
I'm sorry. I know somebody
disease.
Right now who has it. It's terrible.
I know another one too.
It's horrible.
Scott Ledoux, the boxer, has it now.
Is it true?
Yeah.
All right. Look, we can go down the old road of our battle. You do not like the Bush administration.
No.
All right, you don't like Dick Cheney. I got that. I understand that. But I want to ask you some new questions.
All right.
All right, if you're game.
Sure.
All right? Because what is it? What do you think of Barack Obama?
I think he's exceptionally intelligent when you hear him speak and through.
He reads a teleprompter. Oh, come on.
Well, at least we got a president now who can read one.
Listen,
you know, we didn't have
that. That's not a sign of intelligence.
Years. Yes, it is.
No,
if you're not capable of reading a teleprompter.
No, it's not.
No, I'll say this. I think he's very intelligent. I think it's far too early to be judgmental because let's face it, he inherited a mess. He inherited two wars. Mm. He inherited economy
you
in
can't
the tank.
Stop yourself.
Economy in the tank, two wars. Right. I wouldn't have wished that on my worst enemy.
Well, George Bush inherited a recession. George Bush inherited the negative.
No, he
let
did
me finish.
Not.
Yes,
George,
he. Oh, yes, he
wait
did.
Wait a minute.
Oh, yes, he
if
did.
We sat
and
here,
the negative impact of 9/11.
All right. You're telling me that the United States was better off after George Bush or before him?
After.
Oh, my God. How can you make that statement?
You just did. And I'll tell you why.
Well, I don't even need to talk to you about it.
Listen, it's not about Republicans.
It's ridiculous. This country was far better off before George Bush than it is after George Bush.
Want me to quote you the 9/11 Commission report? For an entire decade. I'm glad I can make you laugh.
You
for
can.
An entire
when you
decade,
bring up the 9/11 Commission, that makes me laugh.
For an entire
because they didn't investigate nothing.
Well, I agree. And to one extent, you're partially right, but they did get one thing right, that there were a group of radicals that were at war with the United States, and we weren't at war with them.
Yeah.
We saw the first Trade Center bombing, the embassy bombings, the USS Cole, and we have radicals that think God is going to reward them in heaven with virgins, Jesse. How do you stop them?
Well,
what do you do? Tell me what you do.
You pay attention to memos on August 6th that tell you exactly what bin Laden's going to do. Instead, we hear Condoleezza Rice going, I didn't know what they were going to do. And the memo says, bin Laden set to hijack planes and ram them into buildings.
I have a better idea.
And your buddy, George Bush,
he
was on vacation in Crawford at the time. Did you know he took over 900 days of vacation?
No, president's never off. President, do you know that? Let me give you an example.
This one was, he wasn't on his watch because the biggest attack in history happened on his watch.
I wrote about this in my first book. I'll give you a copy before you leave here. Bill Clinton was offered Osama bin Laden on a silver platter by the Sudan, and we passed on him five times. So I don't want to hear lectures about George Bush and bin Laden. He did keep us safe. He did put us on a war foot.
And let's see. George Bush was bailed out of one of his bad business deals by Salem bin Laden, Osama's brother.
Can I ask you this question?
There's a connection there?
Right.
Come on.
Let me ask you this. Do you not think the quadrupling of our national debt, which in one year,
I
one
agree.
Year, would you do that if you were president?
No, I don't know. Because I would. I was talking about the deficit before the election, and not. Yeah. And you notice that term never came up.
I agree.
Do the entire John McCain, Osama bin Laden election, nobody would touch the deficit with a 10-foot pole.
If you,
do you know who first brought up the deficit?
Yeah.
Ross Perot.
It's true.
That's right.
True. That's
and,
true.
And so don't come at me that all the Republicans do, they spend like Democrats, only they charge it.
Listen.
At least the Democrats go cash and carry. The Republicans do the same thing and charge it.
I will tell you this, though, but in 1 year to quadruple the deficit, to have the CBO tell us that in 10 years, let me finish. Well, kids and grandkids, but in
no,
10 years
George
we're going to quadruple. And no, that's not true. No, this deficit is Obama's deficit. This is Obama's spending. Obama did
it in one year to fix George Bush's mess.
You just hate Bush so much you can't see straight.
No, that's
you can't
true.
See straight.
You can't
He's
see
not
straight
the president
because you're so conservative.
I'm a conservative.
All you do is
that's
back
right.
the conservatives
Wrong.
No matter what they do.
Wrong. You haven't listened to me for 5 years criticizing Republicans for spending too much money. Say that's right, Mr. Hannity.
Mister, you're not my officer.
I'm not. Jesse, the body. Good to see you. Do you have a good time?
I'm done already. This is it.
That's it.
Jeez, you didn't even get to any good topics.
Because you insist on going over the old topic, and I knew you'd do this.
Because I need to pound it home to people to have them realize Barack Obama inherited this mess. Republicans had the Congress for 6 years, and they had the presidency.
Now it's Obama's mess, and Obama quadrupled the deficit in 1 year, and we'll see what happens to our kids and grandkids.
Okay, well, George Bush had a bailout too, didn't he? And you know what's interesting?
Are you ever going to run for office? I don't care what you say about
Republicans
Bush.
Voted for it when it was George Bush's bailout, but they wouldn't vote for it when it was Obama's. That's politics at its worst. That's putting your party before the country.
I am a Reagan conservative.
I'm a Goldwater conservative.
Well, I'm a Reagan conservative. We just disagree on social issues on many things.
Yeah.
Reagan gave us the longest period of peacetime economic growth. He ended the Cold War, and he took on evil in his time, and I love him for it.
Okay.
And Bush kept us safe. Goodbye. Thank
kept
you.
Kept us safe. The biggest attack in history on his watch.
Yeah, okay.
Don't tell
thank
me
Bill
he kept
Clinton
us safe.
That.
No, I'll thank George Bush who don't read memos and who goes on vacation
you
and sleeps.
You should have blamed Clinton for not getting bin Laden when he was off.
Well, I'll put it to you this way. I'd rather have 1,000 Monicas than all these 9/11s and the terrorists.
I don't know why I like you, but I do. All right,
coming up. Because I tell you the truth, that's why.